Hello everyone, welcome back to another ViteConf. Today, I'm here to talk about the state of Vite. What's been happening, how things are going, what's going to happen next. Let's dive right into it. First, let's do a quick recap of the releases since last ViteConf. There was a lot of work that went into each release, but here, we're going to mostly focus on some of the most notable features. Vite 4 was released in December 2022. Shortly after last ViteConf. The main change that warranted a new major was the upgrade to rollup 3. The two projects synced the major releases together, so we can also sync the discontinued support for old Node.js versions. Compared to Vite 3, this was a much smaller major release in terms of breaking changes. In fact, our goal was to ship a stable major. We heavily leveraged our ecosystem CI to ensure compatibility with downstream projects so that the changes would affect end users as little as possible. We also adopted the SWC-powered React plugin, originally created by Arnaud Baer, who is now also a team member. For Core, in 4.1, it was mostly about syncing rollup and ESBuild versions. The more notable changes were in the React plugins. Plugging React fixed a lot of HMR edge cases, while the SWC-powered version added support for SWC plugins. The highlight for 4.2 was improved source map debugging experience. We collaborated with the Chrome DevTools team and fixed some long-standing annoying path display issues. So now you will see nice relative paths when you're debugging source files in the Chrome DevTools. And we also added the options to exclude files from stack traces via the ex-Google ignoreless source map extension. When you turn this option on, you can ask Vite to generate source maps that exclude certain files in the stack traces. This option is leveraged by higher level frameworks like Nuxt and Angular already to make your error stack traces focus only on the parts that you care about. Now, 4.3 is an exciting one. It was a performance-focused release that results in up to 4 times faster code startup and up to 2 times faster hot module replacement. The main optimization was a rewritten resolve strategy. But the overall improvement was a result of many different optimizations the team carved out piece by piece across the code base. This was a tremendous effort. We're really proud of this release. In 4.4, we added experimental support for Lightning CSS. Lightning CSS is a fast CSS compilation toolchain written in Rust. It is an opt-in feature for Vite. You'll need to explicitly install Lightning CSS to let it handle Vite's internal CSS transforms, such as import and lining, and CSS modules. It can also be used for CSS minification, but do note it's currently mutually exclusive with other CSS preprocessors. On the other hand, we also added Solid and Quick templates to create Vite. So when you do npm init Vite, you also have the option to scaffold a Solid or Quick project out of the box. Lastly, 5.0 is currently in beta. Again, this is aimed to be a stable major, where the main change is really about dropping support for Node.js versions that are now end of life. Another thing to mention is that we are deprecating Vite's CommonJS API. Note that the API isn't removed directly. So if you're still using the CommonJS API of Vite, nothing will break, but you will get a little warning that nudges you towards the ESM API. We've also worked with most downstream projects to use the ESM API if they are not already doing so. Again, the main focus of this new major is to make sure it affects end users as little as possible. However, if you like living on the edge, do help us test it out and report issues. Now that we are all caught up, let's take a look at how things are going in terms of growth and adoption. We're closing in on 60,000 stars as I am recording this video, and I believe we should have passed that by now, at this moment you're watching it. The NPM download count is even more impressive. We're now at 7.2 million weekly downloads, a 4x growth over the past year. That is almost 30 million downloads a month. Shout out to all the Vite users out there. Thank you for the support. Now, we're also seeing even more adoption and matured support in the ecosystem. Storybook 7, released in April, now comes with first-class Vite support. Angular 16, released in May, now uses Vite as its dev server. Preact switched its default tooling to Vite in June. And Redwood, which released its V6 in July, is now fully built on top of Vite. Bun, the new JavaScript runtime, has been supporting Vite since 0.7. In fact, if you scaffold a new project, Vite project today with Bun, it will just work out of the box. VitePress, the static site generator that powers the documentation of Vite itself and also that of Rollup, Vue, and many more, is about to reach 1.0 soon. And I'm very excited to announce that we've been working with the Remix team on exploring a migration to Vite. And it's already gotten pretty far, so expect to see a Vite-powered Remix in the near future. It's clear that Vite is becoming a foundational piece of software, with more and more projects building on top of it. The cool part is, all these projects are innovating in different directions. To me, this diversity has always been the beauty of the web. This convergence around Vite is not a sign of uniformity in terms of ideas. On the contrary, Vite's mission is to free developers from the duplicated efforts and complexity at the build tool layer, and serve as a shared foundation that facilitates easier, faster, higher-level innovations in the web ecosystem. I really appreciate Jason's quote here, because it is affirmation that we've got something right. The balance between abstracting away enough lower-level complexity while exposing enough flexibility for advanced users and framework tooling authors. To continue to serve this goal well, we've summarized a few guidelines as the project philosophy. A lean and extensible core. Pushing for the modern web. A pragmatic approach to performance. Support higher level frameworks. And foster a collaborative ecosystem. Matthias will talk about these in much more details in his talk, but I think the last two points here are particularly important. Vite is where it is today because of its collaborative ecosystem, a group of open source projects building on a common foundation, innovating in different directions, and inspiring each other along the way. So, what's next? How can Vite carry out its mission even better? What is still lacking? And what can we improve? I will be the first person to acknowledge that Vite is far from perfect. Here are some pain points based on the feedback we've collected from Vite users. For example, relatively slow production build speed. This is probably the biggest pain point because we are still using Rollup for production build, and the speed compared to purely native bundlers like ESBuild or Bun, the difference is huge. There's also inconsistency between development and production environments. This mostly happens because during development, Vite is using a hybrid strategy where your source code is served using native ES modules, while the dependencies are pre-bundled using ESBuild. Now, in production, we use Rollup to bundle everything. So as you can see, the handling of CommonJS and the handling of the way modules are transformed can sometimes have slight inconsistencies, which are difficult to debug for the end user. Now, there's also the network overhead of unbundled ESM during development. Some users may have projects that have a huge amount of unbundled ES modules that where the network overhead end up impacting the initial page load speed when you're doing development. This is particularly bad when some users have to develop behind a proxy. So the network overhead is somewhat compounded during these scenarios. And then there's the confusing SSR external issues. A lot of users using high-level meta frameworks have probably run into this and have no idea what this means or how to resolve them. And there's also limited control over chunk splitting. Rollup is already offering a lot of flexibility compared to ESBuild, however, compared to Webpack, which gives a very powerful code splitting option that allows you to fully customize how your chunks are split in production, we still want to see some improvements in this front. And finally, there's the lack of first-party module federation support. In Webpack, this is a first-party feature. In Vite, we also have users who've created plugins for this, but a lack of first-party support makes it quite difficult to make Vite applications leverage this feature confidently. So, these problems are not new. Most of them have been around since the day one of Vite. The challenge here is that most of them have to be solved at the bundler level. If you're familiar with Vite internals, you'd know that we leverage two bundlers, ESBuild and Rollup under the hood. The fact that we have to use two bundlers is because they're great in different ways, but cannot fully replace one another. ESBuild is extremely fast, but it has very limited control for build asset optimization. You really don't have many ways to control how the chunks are split, which is very important if you want to optimize for loading performance to the end user. Its plugin API is also not flexible enough compared to rollups, especially when you're trying to chain multiple plugins together to work on the same file type, right? It's worth mentioning that Buns Bundler is largely a port of ESBuild, so most of the things we talked about here about ESBuild also applies to Bun. On the other hand, Rollup is very mature and flexible, but it is still slow compared to native bundlers. There's also the issue of handling of ESM-CJS interop. When you have a mixed graph in your project, the handling there can be improved. There are often issues when we're handling weirdly compiled CommonJS dependencies or FoxESM dependencies. And we've had multiple iterations of the CommonJS plugin in Rollup, but still to today, we still have occasionally find issues that are difficult to tackle. So it would be really nice if we can have a bundler that has native speed, but also the flexibility and maturity of Rollup. Introducing Rolldown, a Rust port of Rollup with slightly larger scope. Rolldown is a new project that we've been working on, and hopefully we'll be able to eventually put into Vite. The focus of Rolldown is performance with a best effort compatibility with Rollup APIs. The goal is to switch to it in Vite with minimal impact on the end user. The current status Rolldown is an early work in progress. The original Rolldown project was started quite a long time ago and was more or less the predecessor to RSPack, which is ByteDance's Rust port of Webpack. Today, we have the original authors of Rolldown, who are also RSPack core contributors, working on a new version of Rolldown, written from the ground up, but with the knowledge and experience from these previous iterations. We currently have a prototype that is able to bundle plain ES modules, but still have many architectural level decisions that we need to validate. At the moment, the code base is going through a lot of changes, but we hope to be able to open source it soon as we arrive on something more stable. We will be collaborating with the RSPack team on some shared lower level tools and features. For example, we'll both be building on top of OXC, currently the fastest JS POS written in Rust. We will also look at how we can make module federation work across RSPack and Vite. And of course, we'll be collaborating with Lucas, the maintainer of Rollup, to ensure APN and behavior consistency between Rollup and Rolldown. Writing a bundler in Rust from the ground up is not a small undertaking, and we are well aware of the effort it requires. That said, we are fully committed to making it happen. It will likely take some time though, and the integration with Vite will have to happen in stages. Here we'll take a look at the planned roadmap and the milestones from short term to long term. The first stage will focus on basic bundling. The goal is to be able to replace ESBuild for dependency pre-bundling, where the key challenge is good handling of CommonJS and FoxESM dependencies. We're currently working on this stage, and hopefully we'll have this ready by the end of the year. The second milestone will be Rollup feature parity. Most importantly, compatibility with rollup plugin ecosystem. On top of that, we also need to implement tree shaking and advanced chunk splitting control. The goal of this stage is to be able to use rolldown instead of rollup for production builds in Vite. This is much more demanding than stage 1, and we expect it to take much longer time at this stage. And the challenge here is to making sure the behavior stays consistent with rollup so that it will bring as little disruption to the end users as possible. Plugin compatibility will also be tricky, as there will be some trade-offs that we'll have to make between full compatibility and performance optimizations. We'll likely introduce a subset of the plugin interface or introducing new hooks necessary for users to author plugins that are maximally compatible with the performance requirements of the lower level bundler. But rest assured, we'll try our best to make sure all existing plugins today work smoothly. They may de-opt in terms of performance in some places, but our goal is to get most plugins running smoothly out of the box. Now, stage 3 will be a bit far out. This stage will involve built-in transforms for some of the most common needs, for example, TypeScript, JSX, minification, and syntax lowering based on target environment. Again, the TypeScript handling here will only do transpiling. It will not handle the type checking, which you should still use TSC for that. So the scope here is quite similar to ESBuild. The goal is to reach feature parity with ESBuild in this category of features. So we will eventually replace both ESBuild and rollup with rolldown inside Vite. For the long run, we're also thinking about how Vite itself can benefit more from native level speed. One possible way to achieve that is for rolldown to expose the plugin container via a Rust API. Vite will then also introduce its own Rust core, which leverages rolldown as a dependency. With this structure in place, we'll be able to Rustify more Vite internal plugins and transforms that are in the critical paths for performance. For example, we can Rustify the resolver, we can Rustify the import analysis plugin that is used almost on every single module. We can also Rustify the SSR load module transform, which is used for handling the SSR runtime transforms. Now, Rustifying SSR load module is important because given that it will be fast enough, it makes performance less of a concern when doing these SSR transforms. And the reason we introduced SSR externals in the first place was to avoid this expensive transform. So if we can make the SSR transform fast enough, then we can just ignore the SSR externals requirement and completely make that whole category of problems disappear. And finally, we can also potentially introduce a full bundled mode for projects that simply have too many unbundled modules or are developing behind a proxy. The full bundle mode will work more similar to how traditional bundlers like Webpack works, but we will likely still leverage native ESM for hot module replacement. This is a bit of far out, but this is something we are indeed considering because we noticed that for some users, unbundled modules is in fact a performance killer during development, especially on page reloads as well. Finally, I want to emphasize that the purpose of rolldown is not about replacing existing tools or be a better alternative to X. Its purpose is to better address the unique needs that we are facing in Vite and eventually benefit all the users building on top of Vite. We are standing on the shoulders of giants, and we deeply appreciate all the hard work that went into ESBuild and rollup. So that concludes my talk. I hope you are excited as I am about the future of Vite. And make sure to tune in to all the other amazing talks that are coming up. Thank you.